Hi, my name's Matt Fuller. I'm a full-time comedy magician from Johnson City, Tennessee, and I'm going to do something unusual. We've all seen a lot of the same magic tricks. The old rabbit in the hat, cutting the lady in half, pencil through the eye. I want to be different. And I think we've all seen enough squid magic. So I'm thinking, how about a magic trick with a deck of cards? Just an idea. I need a helper. Would you mind helping me? There's a beautiful lady right here. What's your name, Becca?
Becca.
Becca. This is Becca. Now, Becca, check out the box. Make sure it's okay. Does it seem normal to you?
Looks normal.
That's great. We won't need that. Do you know one card from the other?
No.
Which one's the other? These are confusing questions. Perfectly fine. I want to be fair. Take your finger and just touch a card. It doesn't matter which one. Anyone you like that one? Are you happy? You want to change your mind? Check it out. Don't forget what it is. I'll show it to our studio audience as well. And you can hold on to the card. Shuffle it. Mix it up thoroughly. Now, Becca, I'll have you put the card back here. Don't forget what it is. This is a great little trick. I learned this from a guy named Johnny something. I forget his name. Anyway, some people said he was mixed up. He wasn't mixed up at all. Well, I mean, he was a little mixed up. He said he was a Hindu, but not a real Hindu. I don't know what that, you don't care. You really don't care, do you? Okay, move forward just a hair where you can be under the bag. Here's the magic trick. If I give the cards a little flick with the wrist, one card flies out of the deck into my pocket just like that. Pretty good, huh? But is it really your card? That's the question. What was the card you picked?
Six of diamonds.
Six of diamonds. I'll check. Yes, that's it. It's pretty good, right? This is a tougher audience than I'm used to. We'll do it again. You did a double. You know that? You were like, whoa, did that really happen? I'm going to do that. You know, let me tell you something about magicians. Very strange. We'll sit up all night long trying to figure out how to get this card from here into the pocket. And I have a solution. If you hold it this way, you see I'm holding the card? If I just put it in the pocket like that, problem solved. So much better. But magicians won't get a round of applause for doing that, so they won't do it. But now that you know what's going to happen, pay close attention. Is it going in about the center of the deck? Is that really your card? Watch closely. I'll even show you that it really is in the deck. Is that it?
Mm-hmm.
Hofzinger. That was the guy's last name, Johnny Hofzinger. I couldn't think of it. You really don't care. Just be honest. A little flick of the wrist, one card flies through the air, reappears in the pocket. You know, the problem with this trick is that people don't really believe that's your card. I mean, I could have a pocket full of six of diamonds, am I right? So let's mark it. You can hang on to the card, check it out, make sure it's okay. And we're going to write your initials on that card. But since I know your name's Becca, I want you to make up a name, something I wouldn't know, you wouldn't possibly know, just like you came up out of the audience. Just name a name.
Gloria D.
Gloria D. All right, here we go. There's the G for Gloria and the D right there. So that's the only card like that in the world. I should have put the D on that side. I don't know. I did that because I'm nervous. Sometimes when I get nervous, I do things that don't make any sense. Would you hold that? Thanks. Are you a magician?
No.
Okay. You really appreciate that if you're a magician. See how I put the card in the deck, this thing? Would you say that's about halfway through? If that card jumps from the deck into my pocket, you'd have to say that's really magic. Would you agree with that? A little flick of the wrist, one card flies through the air and reappears. I don't have it. You know what would be even better? If it jumped out of the deck and reappeared in your pocket. Check it out. Is it in there?
No.
Is it? It's not? Well, that's because it jumped out of your pocket, hit the ceiling, made three revolutions in midair, and then reappeared back in my pocket. Check it out, Becca. Is this really your card, the six of diamonds with the Gloria and the D? Is that really it?
Yes.
Is that really it? Isn't that great? That's an awesome trick. I'm going to show you how it works, okay? Now, here's the magic. I put the card in the deck this way, but I don't put it in all the way. I kind of leave it sticking out a little bit. You see how I do that? I thought of this the other night when I was out jogging. Anyway, here's the secret. Up my sleeve, I have a hook. It's an invisible hook. And it grabs the card from the deck, pulls it to the shoulder, where I have a spring. That shoots the card from here to here, then a weight that slides the card down the sleeve. Then there's an actual rod up the sleeve that will push the card. I never show it to people. You know, I want them to look and go, oh, you know, I say, is that really it? Because I want to keep them in suspenders. Am I right? I like to keep people in suspenders. Here's what we're going to do. So you don't think I'm cheating, I'll put the card in the middle. I think that's about the middle. I want you to see the card. Can you see it in there? You can see the little initial and everything. It's going to jump from the deck into the pocket. Don't blink. Trust me here, it's not like I'm going to slip something on the side. Did that look normal to you? It didn't look like I did anything funny or anything like that? Good. The card goes from here, up the sleeve, across the shoulder, down the other side. And it's so much better if I just use my fingers, you know, instead, or the whole hand, to reach into the pocket like this, Becca, and take out one card. Believe it or not, nothing here. Check it out. Is that really your card? These six of diamonds with the Gloria and the D? Is that pretty good or what? You can check that out. Keep that as a souvenir. The neat thing about it is you can actually look through the deck. If we had time, you can look through the deck and see that there actually are no other sixes, no other duplicates. That's the only one, and that is the trick. Thanks.